Why is everything a missile turret? Yeah, looks like it's on this. I think we're all set here, I think. Although everything's a missile turret. So, I think we're pretty much done here. Yeah, a whole bunch of guns. Oh, here we have to connect these missile launchers. Just wire them up. I mean, the defense number is so off the chart at this point, it's not even funny. I mean, truly, truly, if anything were to spawn that wasn't even halfway friendly here. Yeah, it's not gonna last very long at all. No, no. Let me give you a little tour. We do have some defense posts. We've got 4 artillery pieces there, 4 on that side. Well, as you can see, 803 water. We can add more, but it's getting to the point where I don't know if I can spend it as fast as I can make it there, so may as well save that for a day when I just really feel like making water. And, let's see. So, oh, them guns down this way. Of course, in other videos, we have detailed the cereal bowl, as I call it. We'll take a walk over that way in a little bit. Let's go downstairs inside the bunkhouse. There's a really great view there of the Pridwin. That's great. Looks happy out here today. It's a happy-looking day, even with all the debris and distraction. All right, let's just go down the stairs here. Might as well take it out of that screen. Not going to be building too much. You got some extra bunks here. The boss. So, kind of hangout place here. Primarily for Kate. Did this up as though it'll be my hangout spot if I'm here. Have to get some liquors in there. Although she's supposed to be, you know, turned over a new leaf with a lot of that stuff. You know, an ice machine, a Nuka-Cola machine. Get some stuff up there. That's just jammed up there. I'm trying to manipulate these things. You can see alarm clocks knocked over, some comfy pillows, a teddy bear, and jangles. This landed straight up. You can't move it anyway. I'm like, alright, that's, we're just going to leave that in the way there. Television, a coffee pot, you know, some stuff. This would be true for being Spectacle Island, you know, some tribute to the Mike Lurks. We've got, we're not too bad, not too shabby looking, is it? There she is, Kate. I have to admit, I kind of set Kate up a little bit better than I did Piper. Piper's got a nice set of digs out at the slug, but I mean, you have so much more available to you out here. And I do feel a little bad because I'm treating Kate as a side chick here. You know, it's not something I do in life. You know? So we should put some power around the back. The power's a little bit iffy at times. Where you get it and where you don't. Thought I had enough. Around the backside. Run this way and run that way. So here's some more that have a bunch of robots. They're not modified robots. I just made as many robots as I could to get the functionality. Yeah, we have a few. We need really a few more robots. So we have one at every one of these positions, but let's see. Let me see now. Maybe if I go back down to power. Just need connectors and switches. Now, this is something I've only just recently figured out, is that these power pylons are kind of an area effect thing. So, you don't actually have to connect, necessarily have to connect them to, like, the wall with a connector or anything like that. Although, sometimes it seems like you do. So, still not sure if that's as consistent as, a consistent A thing. Attach wire. That should get a bunch of lights going. Can I put a wall connector up here just for her room? High up on the room there. And then attach wire. Thank goodness I don't actually have to climb that. And then up there. Yeah, you can see, really, there's some times when you just have to do bad games with concrete when you're playing with this game. Or, unless you have, you know, something called patience, with which, you know. Patience. Take this one around this side. We'll just get as much power going in this place as we can. Can't break the, okay, well, let's tab that. We can just reselect it. Bring it out a little bit. So we can get the angle on the wire. And then, power pylon here. Power pylon, say, here. The other way, here. Now we're out of rubber. Okay, so we're really... I've been building so much, I'm actually gone from having more junk than you know what to do with to really needing more stuff. I've built myself poor again. Now I'm okay with that, because that's what it's for, after all. Now let's see. Did that have any effect on the overall conditions in here? Looks like we got lights just about everywhere here now. That's all good. Except right in the middle there, but that's, I'm okay with that. And yes, alright, all of her lights are on. Handcuffs. Alright, we can leave them full. Well, I think they will look better if they're not impossibly laying on the... Yes, there's a joke there someplace. Like I was saying, you know, it's a funny thing. This whole multiple romantic relationship thing is not something I've kind of pursued in life. And I feel funny doing it, but I suddenly realized why it works in the game, whereas it feels funny, is that there's something extremely disconnected from real life with the way your companions work. And this is all the companions. Once you have reached a level of friendship, you don't have to do anything to maintain that. And that's fine with friendship. I have friends. Well, they're friends of mine for decades. 3 decades, easy. Some of them. And, you know, I can call them up. Haven't talked to them in 3 years. And it's like we had never stopped talking. Like, we haven't, you know, seen each other in a long time. We're all busy. We've all got a lot of things going. We're in different parts of the country. And friendships, yes, you can have that where you pick it right back up. Romantic relationships, however, they require work. They require effort. They require constant maintenance. And that's not the case in this game. In this game, Kate's going to be my lover whether I don't see her ever again. I just show up. I don't know. Maybe that's how it works for some people. It's generally speaking how it works for moi. I find that if you want to keep a relationship going, you got to keep working at it. So I've had Piper up at the slog. I don't know how long. I haven't been up there in a while. Probably won't go up there until, you know. You're just posing by that boss sign. You like that, don't you? That works. Let's continue the tour here while we talk about this whole thing here. So that's the one thing where if you try and do that in real life, you're going to run into some problems. Because, at least in my experience... relationships need maintenance, and that's just something that goes on. Not in this world, though. I mean, the post-apocalyptic, everyone's like, yeah, you know what, hell with it. As you can see, we have just about every crafting tool available here. And on other videos, we've demonstrated the cereal bowl. In case you're curious how this kind of works, if you have a switching pole here, you run the power to that, and then run, whatever you run from there is on the switch. So you run the wire from there to there, and everything that goes off of there is then connected to the switched power. You can see the door is shut. Should probably leave those doors shut. Just in case I ever do spawn something up here. Not that I'm planning on it. I'm kind of glad I built the cereal bowl. Because it does look cool. I mean, the potential is here for a lot of things. We need some more people here at the Cereal Bowl before we can start manning these stores. Yeah, at the Cereal Bowl. Get cereal? Ha! I'm so funny. Another hero? Anybody get it? Anybody get it? Something we don't need? Oh, I have my light on. You don't need to be green. Don't worry, I'm just looking through the scope. Just looking through the scope, baby. It's okay. don't actually call my wife baby like that. It doesn't really come up, just so you wonder. We've got a lookout up here. Pretty much a full set of Power 2 armor, Raider armor. I think it's at one power, one leg or something like that. We have enough missiles. Do we have missiles? Oh my goodness, do we have missiles? Matter of fact, you know what? I'm going to save here, because if I do fall off of this, it is death. I don't want to have to think back, what did I do, what did I not do? Beautiful view, though. You got a stunning view of everything. There's the bunkhouse. Got the robots heading out to their positions, you know. Hello! I'm trying to think now. Have I ever called her baby? Babe, maybe. But not really. Did she just fall off? Where'd she go? Oh, yep. Fell right off. Thank goodness she's immortal. Lasers. Because you gotta love lasers. How can you not have lasers, right? Got some power going on here. Elaborate power stuff. I was having a lot of fun with the power stuff. That's the quitting time siren. The only thing I don't have up, which I'm going to add at some point, is when I finally put those points into, was it Animal Friend and something else, to get the pacifier so you could have, like, friendly animals and things in here. Although two of the things I ever set up already will never be friendly. There's a feral ghoul and a... what the hell was it? Super Mutant. Dealio. And, of course, we're set up so that you can send settlers in there and then open the doors and let them beat each other up. Or have them fight monsters. Although, it says that if they, the overall population hate it when one of the settlers get killed doing that. And, you know, for as much as it was fun to build this, I don't know. The fights are not exciting. It's not like there's elaborate kind of things going on. It's just people punching at each other and stuff till, you know, stuff's dead, just like it is in game. What you screaming for, Kate? The fall again? We have a cow. I think that's kind of important. And, oh, hey, it's Sea Spray! Sea Spray is my supply line robot. Where's the cow? Sea Spray, did you drown another bovine? Somewhere here there should be a cow, like, flying out of the water. Or not. We got some guns, we got some artillery.
Yes?
Hey there, settler. I'm just saying hey there. And she assigned herself. She just came out. Everybody else is working on food. Oh, here it comes. It is out of the water. You don't have to worry about them, because apparently these Brahmin can breathe underwater. That's how supply lines work. Hey, I'll take it. That's good. And Sea Spray. He just gets to show up. Another defense post here. Not too much built beyond that. We have additional bunks up here. What do we have? How many bunks? We got 46 beds. 620 power, 803 water, 12 food, not a lot of people. 11 people, we only have 12 food. Is anybody working? Where are these 12 people? I don't even see them. Well, they could be all over the place. That is one of the issues with this as a settlement, is the people could be all over the place, just wandering about. Of course, up this way, you'll have, that's the power going to the Keep the Mic Lurk Away ultrasonic signal. Still probably some stuff to explore. I don't know if I've been over, I think I've wandered over this way once. Ah, here we go. Yeah, we got dead people. Look, a dead raider. And it's Randy. Poor Randy. He was one trying to make it all work here before the raiders got him. But Randy will get the proper burial of the wasteland, of course. Duct tape and wrenches. Abandoned to rot in your underwear. That's how I want to go. That's, well, not really. plenty of wood out here. But, you know, I do want to leave some rustic landscape. You know what I mean? Jeepers. Especially when you consider I'm really out of ideas as far as stuff to add on here. You have to add on some power. Although I don't have enough stuff to do that. It's glitching out on me. I only want to do fusion generators. I need rubber and aluminum to do that. If I tap one more fusion generator on here and tie it into this run, I'll get a little bit more water. I think like another 120 water or something like that. And so, you got the decontamination arch, you got a bell. I mean, I can't think of anything else I can do here. Should we try to use the bell? I've never used the bell before. Maybe we could assign some stuff and get some happiness going. Ding. Wow. What is that little ding, and everyone comes running. Including the robots. I don't think I wanted the robots. I guess, you know, if you want to just pull everything into it, do assignments. Okay. Let's go in here. Who's not working? Assigned to food, assigned to defense. Alright, you're working. You're working? Hey, baby, you working? Yeah, you're working. Okay. It says there's 12 people. Settler assigned to food. Settler assigned. I got two settlers. Three settlers. And a ton of robots. Kate's got, she always stands right there whenever I go into workshop mode. I don't know what that is. You got me where the 12 people are. Did they fall into the ground? Are they walking? Found out these scavenging stations will, in fact, generate stuff based on the unemployed population. I don't know if that's a new change. You don't have to sign them. They're not as effective as if you have someone actually on it. I don't see anybody coming. Is it a case of I have to be... No, it can't be that you have to be out of workshop. You need to be workshop for to talk to him. Robots. Well, I'm calling bull on the 11 people here. I don't think so. I ain't seeing it. Doop 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 doop. But there you have it. This is so far what I've got of Spectacle Island. And for some reason, you know, it actually says guard tower. Stuff starts to say, you know, missile turret on everything after a while. There's some glitches that go on. And that, I think that's pretty much, this is how it's gonna remain till I finally find a place to put that little animal pacifier thing. There's a tremendous amount more build space here. You could go completely crazy. If for some reason I end up with like 47 people, then I could certainly keep building. That's really ugly. That's profoundly ugly. Oh, we... Tires. Ooh, we do need rubber. Ooh, more rubber. See, it's part of the beach cleanup kind of thing we have going here. And for the most part, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go back, pick up Nick for the short turn. Stairs. That's interesting. I'm going to pick up Nick. I'm going to have her come back here. And this is going to be Kate's place. And, you know, mainly I built the cereal bowl just so she can feel at home. Anything out here that's interesting? Thank God for the Aqua Boy perk. Can't scrap the boat. Okay, we got a shovel, a dead guy, a life preserver, a grave, multiple graves. Who the heck's been buried out here? And who died trying to bury them? Another barrel. Yeah, it's all a lot of sad stuff. Debris. There's the most generic thing I've ever seen. And now you don't want to chop too much up here because, you know, that's the boat with the power and the blah 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 where you have to get everything going. Now I could go way out here and you can watch Kate running like crazy to catch up to me, but yeah, I'm gonna stay in so many dead people here. I have to say, it's been very peaceful here. I mean, unless we have somebody, you know, like a feral ghoul or something trapped up in one of those boxes, it doesn't seem like anything comes after it. Could be because my defense is probably twice what's listed there at 99999. Well, 999999. Okay. Kudos if you can pick out what game reference that's from. And this is it. This is a good view. Here she comes. Yay! Kate, this is your place. I'm leaving you in charge. With all the wandering robots. And the people who are off hiding. Bunkhouse over here. Do you get to see the little where it says bunkhouse? I did do some... I do like the neon. Up here, the bunkhouse. And in case you wondered where you were... Up on the side somewhere. Yeah, you have to go out a little bit. Way up on the top. Spectacle Island! Yeah, behind all those guns. Move the guns. Maybe you should move two of those guns just so you can see better. There you go. That's so much better. Spectacle Island. It's daytime. Okay, let's take a nap. 10 o'clock at night, and it's still kind of bright out. 10 o'clock, last time I checked, 10 o'clock at night was not dusk. Here we go. Spectacle Island, there you have it. And orange and blue. And nobody can see that, but I can see it. It makes me, there you go, it makes me happy. And really, when you're playing the game, isn't that really what it's all about? On that note, how shall we end this? Maybe you're looking at that sign. Not really. We haven't really touched anything over there, that's all as it was. And you're looking at Spectacle Island. From the food. This is the Black Knight, everyone. Have a great night. Looks like he's moo-walking. Perfect picture. Especially if I forget where I put her. Yeah, I was looking at you, kid.
How are we doing on the hunt for Eddie's tapes?
Still searching for them.
Let me know when you manage to get your hands on him.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road again? Get back to the hunt for Eddie Winter?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
All right, Nikki. Watch yourself out there.
Don't worry, Kate. I will.
Send Kate to... Spectacle Island. Confirm travel. I'll miss you. I think you'll be happy.